السلام عليكم، صباح الخير، كيف حالكم؟ أتمنى أن تكونوا بخير. Last lesson we did do it and we identified the elements of the body. Today we are going to write a body about our day in the school. Let's revise very quickly what we have learned last lesson. تكلمنا عن العرض. We talk about the body of the recount. We have an example here of a body of a recount. Let's read it and we find what do we need to include in our writing. أولا في الساعة السابعة استيقظت من نومي ثم غسلت أسناني بالفرشاة والمعجون بعد ذلك رتبت سريري لاحقا لبست ملابس المدرسة وأخيرا أكلت الفطور وذهبت إلى المدرسة. So when you are writing the body, العرض, you need to use روابط, connectives, to link between the sentences. روابط مثل connectives such as أولا, firstly, ثم, then, بعد ذلك, after that, لاحقا, later on, وأخيرا, finally. So you need always, and instead of using just comma, you need to use the connectives also, الروابط. And as we are writing a recount about our personal experiences in the past, you need to find all the verbs في الماضي in the past tense, such as استيقظت, غسلت, رتبت, لبست, أكلت, وذهبت. Let's have an example of a recount to see what do we need to include in our body if we are writing about a day in the school. So نبدأ بالعنوان. We start with the title, يوم في المدرسة, day in the school. In the introduction, في المقدمة, you just give a quick entry to the reader about what you are going to write about. مرحبا, أنا اسمي ماكس. قبل أمس ذهبت إلى المدرسة بالحافلة الكبيرة مع أخي لأتعلم اللغة العربية والحساب. The day before yesterday, I went to the school by the big bus with my brother to learn Arabic and math. Let's go now for العرض. The body, the main paragraph, and the biggest part of the recount. أولا دخلت الصف الخامس. Firstly, I entered year 5 class. ثم قرأت كتابا عن دبي. Then I read a book about Dubai. بعد ذلك تعلمت اللغة العربية. After that, I learned Arabic language. لاحقا استخدمت الحاسوب في درس العلوم. Later on, I used the device in the science lesson. بعد الظهر, in the afternoon, مارست الرياضة في الملعب. I did PE in the football yard. وأخيرا عدت إلى البيت. And finally, I came back home. So as you see in the body, في العرض, you see all the connectives to link between the sentence. You see the verbs in the past tense, مثل دخلت, قرأت, تعلمت, استخدمت, مارست, وعدت. في الخاتمة, in the conclusion, you just conclude what you have written in the body or what you have done in your recount. في رأيي, in my opinion, مدرستي, my school, رائعة, amazing, ومفيدة, very useful. When we are writing our recount about day in the school, يوم في المدرسة, and that's your task for today, here are all the verbs, الأفعال that you need to include in your writing. وهنا الأسماء, here are the nouns that you need to include in your writing. So please read them, familiarize yourself with them, and then start writing your recount as it's shown you in the next part. Your recount should look like that. This is the layout. You need to start with العنوان. المقدمة, the introduction. مرحبا, أنا اسمي. You write your name and then you start finding what do you need to include in your introduction by answering the 6 questions that we have learned before. في العرض, in the body, you need to start with the connectives to link between the sentences, and then you include in the body what you have done in your day in the school. Remember always to use all the verbs في الماضي, all the verbs in the past tense. في الخاتمة, in the conclusion, you need to say just your opinion about how do you find your day or how do you find your school. شكرا ومع السلامة.